Well, it's become pretty obvious that Julia Gillard's high hopes of a regional detention centre in East Timor have fallen over. Not the least because the locals there couldn't handle the whole idea of refugees living better than they do. Now, as we've learned tonight, Papua New Guinea is back on Canberra's refugee radar. Here's Max Futcher with a timely look at not just refugees, but locals in PNG who've fallen through some pretty big cracks.
In one of the world's struggling nations, these are the people on the very bottom rung.
Look, it's an appalling situation and it is very close to our doorstep. Papua
New Guinea. Burundi Dump is on the northern fringe of Port Moresby. And here, every day, hundreds of children join their parents to scavenge through the rotting garbage. They're looking for food scraps, steel for recycling, anything they can use.
The conditions are extremely dangerous, extremely risky for children who live and work at the dump. They are very exposed to disease, to injury, to violence.
Some of the kids have eye disease, many have serious skin conditions. It's tough, but their parents are making the best of their bad lot. Some families have lived here 20 years and the children born here know no different.
Most of the children have one meal a day, predominantly rice. That's nowhere near enough to provide for their nutritional needs, so most of the kids are undernourished as well.
A decade ago, Peter and Matilda Layama were living on the dump. They decided education was the best way out for the children. St. Peter's Literacy School was born with the help of an Australian company. The school's now moved and the children stay there during the week. The goal is to give the children at Burundi and nearby Six Mile Dump a basic grounding, allowing them to graduate to formal education.
Last year, we have 22 who have graduated from this school to primary schools to do grade 3. This year, they are successful.
But there are a lot of children and class places are scarce.
We work like a B plus staff, so chance people only put in beginning in long all, but maybe
without an education, their life opportunities are really diminished. These parents care deeply about their children. They're doing everything they possibly can to help their children survive in this extraordinarily dangerous environment.
But then there are the orphans who have no one to look out for them except the school.
Currently they are sleeping under our house. And then the house is divided into two rooms. One room for the girls, one room for the boys.
In the coming year, Child Fund Australia will help build, among other projects, a dormitory at the school. Until that's ready, they'll sleep under the house next to the pigs.
It will take a long time to turn this around, but change can happen. Change is happening, but it needs a lot of work and a lot of investment.
Almost refugees in their own country.